finally, we head to Carson City, California, where thousands gathered over the weekend to celebrate Philippine Independence Day with an annual parade and festival.
Ain't no party like a Carson party.
Apple Diap of the Grammy-winning group The Black Eyed Peas was honored as Grand Marshal for his work as an artist and humanitarian. While Mr. Pure Energy Gary Valenciano, along with his children Gab and Kiana, brought unforgettable performances on stage.
It's not a full-out concert, but it's enough to kind of just bring people together for an occasion such as this. You know, it's nice when you can bring family over, and it's not just the music. There was food, there was merchandise, there was a lot of other things going on. So people get the entire package, not only in entertainment.
It feels like we're still in the Philippines, and we see the Filipino love for our culture.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
A United Nations report finds both Israel and Hamas guilty of war crimes in the early stages of the war in Gaza. The Commission on Inquiry investigated the Hamas attack on October 7 and Israeli retaliation up to December 31st. It found Israel's action constituted crimes against humanity because of the immense civilian losses. It adds both sides committed war crimes, including torture, murder, and inhumane or cruel treatment. According to the report, Israel has also not responded to several requests for access to its territory and the occupied Palestinian territory. The United States urging a de-escalation of tensions between Israel and Lebanon. On Wednesday, the Iran-backed Hezbollah fired the most rockets it has launched at Israel in a single day since the cross-border hostilities broke out 8 months ago. This is part of its retaliation for an Israeli strike which killed a senior Hezbollah field commander. The Pentagon says U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin has already raised the matter with his Israeli counterpart.
We're going to continue to urge for de-escalation. That was something that the secretary spoke with Minister Gallant about at length yesterday. I'm not going to get into more specifics of the call itself, but we don't want to see a wider regional conflict, and that's why we do want to see a de-escalation of tensions in the region.
Hezbollah and Israel have been exchanging fire for the past 8 months in parallel with the Gaza war. The hostilities are now at their worst since the heavily armed adversaries waged war in 2006. Tight security measures in place as Italy prepares to host the G7 Leaders Summit, scheduled from June 13 to 15. Some 5,000 law enforcement personnel have been deployed in the city of Brindisi and the luxury resort of Borgo Egnazia, where the leaders of the U.S., Japan, Canada, France, Germany, Italy, and Britain will gather to discuss international issues, including the wars in Ukraine and Gaza. A long list of leaders from other countries, as well as Pope Francis, are also expected to attend the summit. U.S. President Joe Biden is among the attendees who already arrived in Italy. Topping his agenda, increasing pressure on Russia over its war in Ukraine and China over its support for Moscow and excess industrial capacity. Biden is also expected to sign a new security agreement with Ukraine to pledge America's long-term support for the country. British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak and Labour leader Keir Starmer face off in a televised debate. The two faced grilling by unhappy voters who challenged them over their past decisions and pledges and how they would fund policies if they win the July 4 election. Sunak was booed and heckled over doctors' strike, migration, and his policy to introduce national service for young people.
But this election now is about the future, and I do believe that we've turned a corner. And when I appreciate that people want to see positive change. And my only point would be that you don't get any change unless you've got a plan and you're prepared to do bold things. And that's what our manifesto sets out.
Looking at wealth taxes, nothing in our manifesto will require.
Starmer, meanwhile, was taken to task for his avoidance of answering questions and his previous support for his predecessor, Jeremy Corbyn.
Nothing requires us to raise tax. And I tell you, I do want you'll challenge me and I want to deal with this. I want to do things differently. I want to grow our economy.
Okay.
I accept that previous Labour leaders have sort of pulled the tax lever every single time and driven up spending. I want to grow our economy.
The inflation is down from 11% back to normal.
With just over 3 weeks until the election, the Labour Party remains on course for an easy victory. A poll taken after the event also shows Starmer winning the face-off.